Now here this slide is showing the variation in the cell on the basis of shapes. Some organisms, they have different shapes in the cells. They have different type of cell shapes. The cells in human body, here we have mentioned the human body cells which vary in their shapes. So in human body, we can see the spherical shaped cells like our blood cells, RBCs, like the egg cell, the ovum, they both are spherical. Here you can see the shape of the cell. Spindle shaped cells, this is called the spindle shaped cell, which is narrow at the points. This type of cell is the muscle, muscular tissue of our body. They have this shape of cell. Spindle shaped cells are there in the muscles. Cells can be polyhedral. Polyhedral means which is not having a regular shape. It has many dimensions. It has many angles. So these are the structures of bone cells which are polyhedral. And sometimes we cannot justify that what will be the specific shape of the cell. Cells are so irregular in shape. So in the shape which is irregular, you can give the example of nerve cell. This is the diagram showing the nerve cell which is irregular in shape. Now, here it should be mentioned in your answer when you are mentioning the different shapes of the cell that the shapes of the cells are determined by their specific functions. What functions the cell has to perform, their shape is according to that, right? The size of the cell varies, the shape of the cell varies, and the shape of the cell varies according to the function of that cell. Now here I want to mention some important points. If the question comes in objective, mostly it is asked the largest cell. The largest cell till now discovered is the ostrich egg cell, whose diameter is in some meters. It is of approx 3 to 6 meters in size. So that is the largest cell. And the smallest cell that is observed is PPLO. PPLO stands for pleuropneumonia-like organism. These cells are in micrometers. And the longest cells are the nerve cells. They are in meters. So the largest cell is ostrich egg cell. The smallest cell is PPLO. And the longest cell is the nerve cells. So these are the variation in the cells according to their shapes. Cells also vary on the basis of their complexity of organization. Now this complexity of organization is dependent, or it is based on spatially the nuclear organization, nucleus. What we have discussed, that nucleus is the brain of the cell. It is the controlling unit of the cell. So what is the structure of that controlling unit? That will also help in categorizing the cells. On the basis of nuclear organization, we have divided cells into two categories, prokaryotic cells and the eukaryotic cells. Here I want to mention pro means primitive, karyotic means nucleus. Cells with the primitive nuclear organization are called prokaryotic cells, and the cells which have U means advanced. Karyotic again means nuclear organization. The cells which have advanced type of nuclear organization are called eukaryotic cells. So let's compare them, and it will be easy for us to recall that what are the differences in prokaryotic and eukaryotic cells, why we are differentiating them, why we are categorizing them in such way. Prokaryotic cells, the best example of prokaryotic cell is the bacteria or the cyanobacteria. Cyanobacteria is also known as blue-green algae. These prokaryotic cells, they do not have a well-organized nucleus. That's why they are called prokaryotic. Here you can see this center part. It is not so well-organized. It is only this thread-like structure. So if the cell does not have a defined nuclear organization, does not have the nuclear organization, they are called prokaryotic. And here you can see this is a definite organized nucleus in the center. So those cells which have a well organized nucleus, they are called eukaryotic cell. So we have shown you the diagram also here, so that it is clarified here only that the cells which have well defined nucleus, they are eukaryotic, which do not have well defined nuclear organization, they are called prokaryotic. These are the diagrams of prokaryotic cell, that is bacteria. This is a bacterial cell, and this is the diagram of an animal cell, which is showing the perfect nuclear organization. Another difference in prokaryotic and eukaryotic cell, that in prokaryotic cell the genetic material DNA is not enclosed with any membrane. There is no surrounding membrane around this genetic material. That's why we are saying it not well defined. Whereas in eukaryotic cell, the genetic material DNA is enclosed within a membrane. There is nuclear membrane. In prokaryotic, there is absence of nuclear membrane. In eukaryotic, nuclear membrane is present. With this, prokaryotic cells also do not have the membrane bound organelles. Organelles, what we understand by organelles? Organs within the cell. Why these organelles are there? To perform specific functions. And each and every organelle is bounded by a membrane. So in prokaryotic cell, membrane bound cell organelles are absent. Whereas in eukaryotic cell, as I have told you, they are advanced. So they have membrane bound all cell organelles like endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi body, mitochondria, plastids, vacuoles. All membrane bound cell organelles are present in eukaryotic cells. Now, so because these cells are primitive, their size will be small. Yes, their size is in between to 1 to 10 micrometers only. Whereas the eukaryotic cells, they are advanced, they are complicated. So their size is also large. They varies from 100 micrometer to several meters. The plant cells and the animal cells comes under eukaryotic cells. And I have told you that nerve cells is in meters. So the eukaryotic cells, they are large sized. The prokaryotic cells are small sized. I hope these differences are clear to you. In exam, if the question comes about the differences between prokaryotic and eukaryotic cell, don't forget to mention these points with diagram. Diagram will help you in better representation of the answer. Clear? So these are the categorization of cell on the basis of their nucleus.